The lack of organization on this French cleat wall has gotten out of hand and become very uninspiring. Well, all that is about to change. The beauty of a French cleat system is that it's so customizable to any space. It's a simple system with two adjacent facing 45 degree angle pieces that interlock, creating a super strong hold. I figure there's no time like the present. It's time to organize this wall, and we're gonna start off by organizing some new clamps. You can see here just how customized you can make these pieces, and you can mount whatever you want, from Bluetooth speakers to your phone to even a massive sound bar. If you wanna see how it all comes together, stick around. Hey, before we get started, guys, let's give a huge shout out to this week's video sponsor. Pony Jorgensen was gracious enough to send us a great selection of their new modern clamps. This is a company that's been around since 1903, but these are not the clamps of old. These things got some serious pressure to them. The bar clamps, 1,000 pounds of pressure. Even the squeeze quick release clamps have 300 pounds of pressure. These are definitely some clamps without compromise. And if you are interested in getting some of these for yourself, there are gonna be links down below to all their social medias and their website. Guys, if you're looking to outfit your shop with some new clamps, this is definitely something I wish you consider. Thank you again, Pony Jorgensen, and let's get to it. Well, here it is. Here's my French cleat wall I built a few years ago. It served me pretty well. As you can see, there is a ton of stuff up here, some of which I don't even use. Some of which needs to be stored in better places. So it's time to go ahead and take down the old one, brush it off, and start fresh. One little aesthetic change I want to make is I want to frame out the entire wall. This is done simply by ripping some pieces on the table saw. And of course I got to notch out a couple things here. As you can see, using the crosscut sled makes quick work of this. I just think this gives it a nice finished look. Well, here we go, the plywood guy strikes again. Yes, Baltic birch plywood is my wood of choice for this project. I'm ripping down some strips that are gonna be 3.5 inches in width and then some 1-inch strips as well. Tilt my blade to 45 degrees and I rip these right in half, and if I've done a good job, you can see they're exactly the same size. Back to the table saw, and I'm gonna knock down these brittle edges that each of these 45 degree angle cuts leaves on each of these strips. All right, so bar clamps. These are heavy, these are massive, it's time to get them organized. 3/4 inch Baltic birch plywood is what I'm using. I'm gonna use some brad nails as spacers, take some measurements, carefully cut some notches into this piece, and it looks like everything's fitting pretty well. Now you can cut these notches on a bandsaw, you can use a router, however, I'm enlisting this fancy crosscut sled that I made a few weeks ago, and it's working really nicely for this. I'm taking a little drum sander attachment for the drill press, I'm gonna break all the edges on all these pieces. So now it's time to build the cleat. I will say this, you need to attach the actual 45 degree angle piece. That angle needs to be going towards the top of whatever you're building. The reason I'm being specific about this is I have built a cleat in the wrong way. Went to install it and realized what a mistake I had made. Hopefully you can learn from my mistakes and don't embarrass yourself like I did. Now we're installing that 1-inch strip on the bottom of the cleat for that bottom support. We're gonna go ahead and install this in the top left-hand corner of the new and invigorated French cleat wall. And everything looks like it's coming together nicely. These bar clamps are awesome, by the way. Now, as the video plays, you're gonna see me make various cleats for various storage solutions. Here's the beauty of this process, is that the French cleat system can be uniquely yours. It's perfect for what you need. I'm not putting plans up for this. I'm not even gonna tell you what dimensions I'm using, because every situation is different for everyone's shop. The reason I'm going through this process of what I'm calling hyper-organization is because my old system was working, yes, it was fine. However, 80% of that stuff that was on the wall was visual noise and I didn't need it on a daily basis. And I want this place to be a sanctuary for me. I want this place really to be inviting, not only for me, but for my kids and for any of my friends that come over to make with us. And honestly, I wanted to inspire you guys as well. So without further ado, let's get back to me describing what I'm doing. So this may be a bit overkill to put a dado into a piece that's only gonna hold 4 clamps, but hey, I wanted to try my hand at it using the crosscut sled like I did a few seconds ago. Worked out pretty well and I'm happy with how it turned out. So one detail I'm holding myself to with this build is that every piece, no matter if it's gonna be seen or behind a wall, is gonna be softened. Edges are gonna be broken. It's gonna feel good. I want this wall to be a thing of art. Even though it's functional, it needs to be a thing of beauty as well. I want it to inspire others who come in and say, wow, you know, I didn't know plywood could look like this. And that's the idea. So every piece you're gonna see me make here has been hand sanded to its where it's soft to the touch. All right, let's bring you in here real quick. I'm gonna show you something. This is a relatively small cleat for a French cleat. So meaning you can put it on the wall, but it might have a tendency to move around if you put some pretty heavy weight on here. So there's a quick fix. A little wedge such as this will wedge up in behind it. You simply just tack it in place, and now you've got a cleat that won't go anywhere. And when you're ready to move it around, which you probably won't very often, you simply just knock it out, move it where you want. Just wanted to show you that, guys. So this little piece goes up on the wall like this, and it stores four of these F-style clamps with ease. Okay, this next clamp storage solution, well, I think this one turned out pretty cool. As simple as this is, I do like how this turned out, and I'm pretty proud of this idea. Anyway, you make a T-joint with some Baltic birch, and you simply attach the cleats on the back. Only attach one because the piece is gonna span actually two cleats on the wall, as you can see here. Use that as a reference, and then go ahead and brad nail in that second cleat. So remember when I was talking about how every little detail is getting my full attention? This is what I mean. This is just the backer piece, and you can see those hand chamfers are done, giving me a nice soft feel on everything. Just wanted to show you that real quick. Okay, back to the super simple storage solution of, yes, you guessed it, squeeze clamps. But here is the cool thing. Not only do they look nice and are organized, but you can take the entire rack with you in case you need to use multiple ones. Okay, for these next clamps, I am listing the piece that I made here. Kind of funky, but you'll see why it is that way in just a second. However, I do need this to be at an angle up, all right? So the idea here, or actually, you know, up like that. So there's the angle I need. Now I'm gonna show you how to cut that on this versatile crosscut sled that we just made a few weeks ago. Let's go do it. So I know this is overkill. I don't need to cut this angle on the vertical piece. I can cut it on the horizontal piece and make my life a lot easier. However, I wanted to test out to see if this stop block system I made on this crosscut sled would work. And you know what? It did. And it did safely. And that's something that's pretty cool. So yeah, you can see that this piece looks a little different than the others, and that will become clear here just in a second. I do want to say this, I did think this needed a little bit more support, so I took a piece and I cut it on the bandsaw, and I hand sanded the edges just right, CA glued it in place, and now it's ready to go. So you can see that groove there is perfect for these clamps to nestle their way home, and this is the beauty of these projects, is that you don't necessarily have to always do this for tools. You can do it for a Bluetooth speaker, you can do it for your phone, which is what this is, as you see here. And then if you want a little more horsepower with your music, go ahead and put a whole sound bar up there. Hey guys, thank you so much for joining me all the way to the end. And I got a special message for you if you are here right now. I take it you're a fan, so here goes. So this project, this small little portion of this French cleat wall was kind of a motivating factor for me. Why? Well, I want this whole entire shop to be as organized and as nice as this right here. So within the next 6 months, that's what I'm doing. This whole shop is gonna get every little square inch of detail and attention to the point where it feels like a safe haven, a maker's sanctuary, right? I say safe haven, yeah, I know I wear flip-flops, but everybody knows, if you're a fan of the channel, they're steel-toe flip-flops, and let's just drop it, okay? Anyway, guys, I invite you to subscribe. Reason being, go ahead and hit that button right there, because within the next 6 months, we are gonna turn this place into a safe haven that only inspires my family, but I hope it inspires you as well. Guys, there'll be a few more videos to watch over here. This has been A Glimpse Inside. My name is Chris, and we'll see you on the next video. Take care.